Love, baby, love. We're talking about love.
Hey, it's Mary, and you're watching Style Sister. This episode's all about love, baby. All about love, okay? You want to find someone. You want to be with someone. You want to find someone that's really cool, man. Well, I got 7 great ways of making that happen. So let's break it down, and let's get you a date, baby. At least a date. And then it's up to you on that next step, okay? So you go to places that would have qualified people there, qualified boyfriend material or girlfriend material. Now, places like, I know this sounds funny, but craft beer events, perfect. It sips out the bottom feeders, you know, the guys that don't give a crap about anything. Like these guys that go to craft beer events, for instance, they like to dress nice generally because they drink craft beer. So, you know, they put a little bit more love into their diet, into what they drink, and craftsmanship into the just themselves in general. On average, you're going to get a better guy in general at an event like this. Go to the Mac shop, you know, go to places where technology is and find the hottest guy there or someone that you're attracted to and go and talk to him and flirt with him. Just say some nice things, you know, laugh at his, you know, stupid geeky jokes. I mean, it's the best way to like break the ice right there. Talk about something he wants to talk about. You know, these ideas, they just come to me. They just come to me out of the ether. Okay. So number two. Be interesting, be engaging. You want to be the kind of person that has something to say. Like go to like Reddit or, you know, some cool website about, you know, some things that are outside of your realm. You want to be more interesting so that you can take on a first date with confidence. That's a great place to start. Go get yourself cultured in something so that you have something to talk about other than sort of just the gossip columns or, you know, Kim Kardashian. You know, be interesting. At a party, one of the best things to say if you're ever looking for something, just if you want to break the ice a little bit, one of my favorite questions I always ask is, what was the first concert you ever went to? With a question like that, I guarantee you'll be the head of the party. Everybody will start talking. People will start laughing as soon as you say what concert you went to. Mine was the Young MC and Sir Mix-a-Lot. Just saying, bam, let your backbone slide. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Totally badass, okay? Number three, send interested signals. When you are talking to someone that you like, make sure you don't totally go inwards and get so nervous that you forget to send out signals that you're actually interested in them. Give them a touch on the arm, give them a touch on the face, or just something, or the hair, like, or just something, anything, like a touch on the hand, just really quick. It breaks barriers so that you touch them, you get close to them, it makes you touchable, it makes you, you know, send out that signal that I am reachable, you can get through this, you know, shield, this armor that I'm wearing, and get to the soft side of me. And everybody wants to get to the soft side. That's how you connect with a person, okay? And laughter and all that jazz, but it's through, you want to break down your armor and you want to break down their armor, okay? So number four, have a life, do stuff. Not only interesting, but you want to have a life. Having a life makes you more interesting, so it really is a win-win situation when you get there. So like, be active, go work out, go dancing, get into art, you know, start a YouTube channel, start a blog, you know, just do something, cook, you know, something that you can talk about and something that makes you richer in your culture, in your just approach to life. You want to be active in it and engaged in the world so that basically once you start dating and once you get to that second, third, fourth date, you've got stuff to do in between those dates that gives you that sense of independence on your own, that you're cool on your own, you've got it together, you're interesting, and you're a well put together person. There's many layers to the onion that you are. That makes you a really cool individual. Number five, baby, number five. Okay, when you go out, if you want to be approachable, definitely don't hang out with a huge group of friends, okay? Because that huge group of friends makes it really hard for other people outside of that group to connect with you. If you can, like if it's a whole big group of girls, that's gonna intimidate guys big time. So like break off into twos and threes and give guys a way to get close to you to maybe ask if they can buy you a drink. But do that so that they can have a second to connect with you and say that, hey, you look pretty. That's the other thing too. When guys give you a compliment, take that compliment. Don't act like, oh yeah, thank you, whatever. I see so many girls diss guys like that and it bugs me. I sit there and I go, do you want a guy to talk to you or not? Like take a compliment or be chill, man. Take it and, you know, be kind. Why is it so hard for people to be kind when they're interacting with other people? Why do they immediately have to think that guy that just talked to you, oh my God, he's such a creep. Like, it really drives me crazy. So stop, change your headspace. There's some nice guys out there, and you just shut them down with a bad attitude. So change your attitude, man. You might be sending off the wrong signals, okay? Right. Just smile. Smile. Make that smile happen, man. And really connect with your eyes with that person that you like. Show them that you're interested. This goes back to the signals. Like, smile. That radiant smile that you have can light up a room. You know it, and I know it. That sends out a big signal that you are stoked and interested in that person and that you want to get to know them better. There is no shame in smiling. I smile all the time, and in fact, that's why I think I really find it easy to connect with people, because I've already broken that, you know, barrier down of unfriendliness. I'm like just friendly right off the bat. I don't care. I lead with my heart, man. You know what? Be confident in who you are. Maybe sometimes you should just put it out there and say, hey, you know what? I'd really like to get together with you. I think you're pretty special. And just put it out there and wait till he answers. And if he says no, or if she says no, then say, whatever, dude, you know, it's better to have loved than to have never loved at all, right? Be confident and own what you say. Before you go on a date or something like that, make sure you call a friend and say, hey, friend, tell me three things about me that you really, really like. So that you go in with a boost of confidence and you're feeling good about yourself. Don't get insecure. It doesn't help you at all. Finally, number 7. Brave the flames. You've got to brave the flames to get the prize. You have to go out there, you have to be confident, like I said, and own it. And deliver your message to that person so that it can really get to the essence of who you are. I mean, why waste time? Again, there's tomorrow, but I mean, why not today? Just skip the bullshit, man. Like, be you and be strong, but be soft and listen to that person too, because it's not all about you. It's about them too, right? This is the coming of two people. So there you go, you guys. That's 7 beautiful things that I really hope get you to, you know, crack open your armor around your heart and get out there and date and find someone that you really care about. Okay, you guys, make sure you subscribe to my channel and like my video, man. Like it, because I say some good stuff on here. You know it and I know it. And share this with a friend that's trying to find love out there. Okay, you guys, so much love. My name is Mary and you're watching Style Sister. Later. Bye.